Hi, my name is Robert Chartier, and this segment today is going to be about negotiations. I'll try to keep it short and sweet. Negotiations are something that never came natural to me, but over 30 years I've honed a relatively strong set of skills. And my name is Robert Chartier. I'm the broker of record of the Chartier Realty Group, DRE license 0117-3785. What many people think about when they think about negotiations in a real estate transaction are post-acceptance, post-offer acceptance, not so much getting your offer accepted, and that's a very big misconception. A really good, skilled, quality, seasoned, experienced real estate agent understands, knows, and has practiced negotiation skills right from the onset of a purchase offer. Because a purchase offer, or whether I'm on the receiving side from a listing and I'm receiving a purchase offer, or I represent a buyer and we are placing a purchase offer on their behalf, that is where the negotiation starts. There's a reason why between the first and third offer that I'm making for a client, even in a heavy, I would say a multi-offer infested market, and today is October 10th, 2012, we are in one of those markets right now. We are not having any unusual difficulties or challenges getting our buyer's offers accepted. We really don't. Why? Because we start the negotiation process right up front. That the offer is the first step to a negotiating tool. And thus the reason why agents that don't understand that, haven't practiced that, and I don't care how many classes they took, I don't care if they've got 10 designations on their name and under their belt, so to speak, all the different designations that are out there, and none of them mean anything more than a day class, so it's kind of a joke, but I'm all about education. I think it's a good thing, but the bottom line is, it's just like the same thing with agents. It doesn't matter what agency that they work for. It always comes down to the individual strength of the agent. There's very good agents in independent offices, and there's very good agents in name brand real estate offices, and there's an equal amount and an equal share of very, very poor agents that are operating in name brand organizations, because it's a big revolving door. It's numbers, numbers, numbers with the big brands. And same with the independents. There's also some very bad, very poor independent agents out there. It's just, we can't escape this. So you want to make sure that an agent that's going to represent you, either on a listing or as a buyer, you better make darn sure that they completely understand the negotiation process and have some seasoning and time behind them. And they better have, you know, at least a couple dozen testimonials to testify to the effectiveness of their negotiating skills, and with some people that they can actually call and talk to. Now, we have those testimonials, but we have to contact people in advance. We don't want people to be badgered by people calling and asking, but we're proud of the fact that we have a large cauldron, so to speak, of testimonials. And we can, in fact, and we do all the time, have our clients call these people. We've got nothing to hide. We do what we say what we do. I say this over and over again. So negotiating skills absolutely start right out the gate. And an agent that is not experienced with that, particularly an agent that gets into this business and they don't have any quote-unquote formal business or formal negotiation training, is at a pretty significant, substantial disadvantage to serving the highest and best interest of a client. And unfortunately, in the state of California, real estate licenses are doled out like driver's licenses. It's much more difficult, and you have to be have a high level of education and experience, for example, even then. In Nevada, to start right out the gate and get a broker's license, you need a four-year degree over there. It should be that way everywhere. But California, you can fall off the turnip truck, and if you're good at taking exams, you can get a real estate license. So be very, very careful, extraordinarily careful about who you select and choose, and understand the reasons why you're choosing that person or individual to represent you in a real estate transaction. Negotiating skills, again, they start from the onset. They start from the when you take a listing, negotiation skills start with how you present that property. How are you positioning that photography? You know, we do home and level home and gardens level photography here. Well, that's positioning strategy. And then the verbiage of how we present that property, even the angles of the photographs. There's a litany of very specific, purposeful steps to how we list properties. That is also the beginning of a negotiation process, because you can't start a negotiation until someone comes to the table to buy your property, that has interest in your property. And then, do you want to start negotiations with a low offer? Or would you like to start negotiations with a little higher offer? We don't think there's anybody out there that's going to disagree with us. Wouldn't you rather start your negotiations with a buyer at a higher offer price? Because that's what it's all about, and that's what a good quality agent is going to do for you, is going to get that higher offer to come in. So you've got more latitude for negotiation. And with the buyers, there's a very good, there are dozens of reasons why purchase offers get rejected, and the ones that get rejected are not written properly, they're not drafted in the right way, they either say too much or not enough about the structure of that transaction, even though the form is a boilerplate. There are a lot of lines and checkboxes on there where you can add or acknowledge or suggest different vendors and for a title and escrow and different, and you can structure a purchase offer in 100 different ways. But there's really only one specific way it should be done, and for each individual client, by the way, also. And it depends upon the property. It's that drilled down, and that being drilled down, going that far down the rabbit hole, is what it takes to be a good negotiator. That negotiation starts from the purchase offer. Not once you've been accepted, because if you don't get accepted in an escrow and you're putting, you know, 4, 5, 6, 8 or dozens of offers in and you can't get accepted, you've got a negotiation problem. That's the problem you have. Your whoever's representing you is not negotiating the first volley, you know, across the net, so to speak, of that purchase offer. It's obviously not being done right, because we're not doing anything magical here to get between the first and third purchase offer accepted. But we focus on the purchase offer as a negotiation point. We start with a good, strong position in the negotiation. If it's a property that we're listing, we want to make sure we start with a good, strong negotiation point. So negotiations start at the listing, and they start at the purchase offer being made on the property. If you have any further questions, feel free to give me a call. My name is Robert Chartier. I'm the broker and the owner of the Chartier Realty Group. You can reach me, the office is 858-273-1861, and you can contact me directly on my cell phone at 858-568-6673. I hope this was helpful. Thank you for tuning in, and have a great day. Bye-bye.